Have you ever sat down in your bedroom studio or million-dollar production office and just thought, wow, these $35 water speakers from Amazon just aren't cutting it anymore? Well, in that case, I have something that might help you out. So welcome everyone, now that you've bypassed the weirdest intro to a video I've ever done. These are the Adam Audio A7Xs, and they are the most beautiful speakers I have ever heard. And they are made out of spaceship materials. So stick around if you want to find out what the hell I'm on about, and also get subscribed if you want to see more weird intros like that. If you want to support what I do and you want to help YouTube recommend my videos in the future, I'd greatly appreciate it. So let's get started. Now, admittedly, I hadn't really heard of Adam Audio before their recent partnership with Focusrite, which now makes Adam Audio a sister company of Novation, who make these, which you might recognize if you've ever been on my channel at any point in the last 8 years. So with Novation solely focusing on hardware and a bit of software at the moment, Adam Audio are entirely focused on making great sounding speakers. Now, I'm no producer by any stretch of the imagination. I have made a couple of songs, admittedly, but that was kind of just to make conversation. So, and because of that, don't just take my word for it. These speakers are used by Cell Dweller and Temonite. That alone should be enough for you guys to get in the description and get some of these for yourself. But admittedly, some of you guys won't know who they are, so let me dig into the technical details to tell you why they're so great. Now, admittedly, I did used to own those water speakers that I mentioned in the intro, but I've come from there and I upgraded to these speakers, which were pretty good for the time. They're kind of more bedroom producer level, you know, sitting around about $150 mark. But these are pretty good. They got me through the time. They're a very consumer level speaker. But I wanted to do a comparison of my differences between a consumer speaker and kind of a more prosumer speaker like the Adam A7Xs. Now, if you don't know too much about the physical design of speakers like this, let me give you a quick history lesson. This is the woofer and this is the tweeter. You'll see these things ranging across a whole bunch of different speaker models, and they both serve a very important purpose. So the woofer is the main speaker cone of the set and is arguably the most recognizable part of any speaker like this. They're usually made out of plastic, and when they're moving, they'll generate sound frequencies anywhere from kind of 50 to 75 hertz, all the way up to roughly 2000 hertz. And then the tweeter does a very similar thing, except it handles around roughly 2000 all the way up to 20,000. So any speaker design like this will have what's called an internal crossover. And this is the point in the frequency range that the signal stops getting sent to the woofer and starts getting sent to the tweeter instead, because the tweeter is much better at handling the higher frequencies. And there you go. That is the pretty much very, very basics of what a speaker is. So why did I give you a brief history lesson on speakers? Well, because I wanted to cover why Adam Audio have decided to do most of those things completely differently. So first off, the A7Xs are way bigger than my old speakers, but that doesn't mean anything without context. So if you take a look at the woofer on the A7X, you'll notice it's black. It's properly stealthy. It looks really cool in the studio, but there's a reason for that. And that is because the speaker in this is made out of a mix of plastic resin, carbon fiber, and glass. And that's not even the craziest part. If you look at the tweeter, it's not even a speaker cone anymore. What the hell is it? I'll tell you what it is. It's this stuff. This is Kapton, and this is used in space for insulation and leak fixing. It's kind of like having a Ferrari for being fast, even if you never drive it fast. It's good to know these things, you know? Ooh. That does not smell good. So the tweeter design on the A7X is the Adam Audio world famous XR tweeter, which is an accelerated ribbon tweeter. And the way that this works is, instead of it being a standard speaker cone, what they've done is they've taken almost 5 times the material of a normal speaker, made it out of Kapton, so it's really thin and can move really fast, and then folded it up a whole bunch so that you get 5 times the surface area, which means that the tweeter has a much better frequency response than anything else on the market. But why would you want a frequency range of up to 50,000 hertz when you can only hear up to about 23,000 hertz anyway? And the reason for that is, if your accepted frequency range goes even higher than the human hearing range, then there's no aggressive roll-off at the top of the high end like there is with a lot of other normal speakers. The only roll-off that happens is the physics in your own ear anyway. I mean, think about it. Just because we can only hear up to about 20,000 hertz doesn't mean that sound just doesn't exist past that range. You know, dogs can hear way up higher than we can, so I'm assuming that the A7Xs would sound really good to them as well. What I'm trying to say is that these speakers sound amazingly natural. They don't pierce your ears, but they're still incredibly crisp. And with practically zero distortion, you're almost guaranteed a good listening experience. So enough about how high the speakers can go, they can go all the way down to 42 Hz. Which doesn't necessarily mean that you can avoid having a subwoofer, because subwoofers tend to go down to like 10. But I have neighbours, and having a subwoofer was probably the worst decision I could ever make.
Sorry, Mike.
But the bass response on the A7Xs makes it feel like not having a subwoofer doesn't really feel like I'm missing out. So I want to talk about the way these speakers actually look as well. You usually don't pay too much attention to it, but if they're going to be a statement piece of your entire studio, it's worth knowing. So, like I've said on the front already, you've got this gorgeous carbon fiber woofer right in the middle, which is surrounded by this metal faceplate with these really steampunk looking screws around the outside of it. So sitting just above that, you've got the world famous designed Atom Audio XArt tweeter, which in contrast with the rest of the speaker, having it pop with that little bit of yellow, is just such a nice little addition to the speaker. So coming down to the bottom, you've got a master volume control for the whole speaker, as well as a on-off switch and a little power LED. So then you've got these two bass ports on the bottom of the speaker as well. This is the area that the air flows into behind the woofer. Because if you can imagine, if you've got that woofer moving at like, or anything all the way up to 2,500 times a second, which is the crossover for these speakers, then airflow is going to get pretty intense, and it's noticeable. But it's not like a fan, you know, the airflow's there, but it's not going to, like, blow you away. The sound will, though. Huh? See what I did there? So, moving it around to the back, you've got the power input, as well as the XLR input, as well as the unbalanced RCA input. So you've also got these three little dials on the back that let you control the level of the high shelf, the low shelf, and also the tweeter level if you want to boost those high frequencies a little bit more. These little dials are my only negative point about the entire speaker, because I've tried taking a screwdriver to them before, and as you can kind of see, the plastic on these dials is starting to get a little bit marred, so I'm kind of leaving it because I don't really want to make it any worse. I've kind of dialed in my settings and I'm going to leave it there now. So the A7Xs aren't made for everyone. There's a very set group of people that I think these speakers are made for, and if you think you're part of that group, then get some for yourself. But if you think you almost fit into that group, then Atom Audio also have the A5X, the A8X, the A3X, and even the T-series of speakers if you're on a bit of a budget as well. So now would be the part in a review video where you guys would expect to find out what this product's like and, you know, have me give you guys a demonstration of it. But these are speakers, and you're going to be listening to this video out of whatever speakers you're on, whether it be a phone or computer, or you might even be listening out of the A7Xs. I mean, I don't know why, if you've already got A7Xs, you'd be watching this video anyway, but even if you do, well, hey, welcome to the A7X gang. So all I can really say past here is that if you guys ever get the chance to go to like a Guitar Center or like a Long & McQuaid or like any other kind of music event where these speakers are probably going to show up, please give them a listen. Trust me, it's worth it. You will see the difference immediately. So like I've said, I'm no producer, I'm no speaker expert by any stretch of the imagination. So if you don't want to take my word, at least take Temanite's word. That should persuade you guys. So yeah, there you go. Hopefully I've influenced you guys enough to get yourself a set of prosumer speakers like the A7X. So yeah, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys in the next video.